Okay, today we're going to learn how to install on the MKS Gen L version 1.4 a servo. So I need to show you a couple things here. First of all, we have our servo pins that are located here, and they go all the way across. There's four sets of pins with three pins on them. So the top pins, this would be digital pin 11, this would be digital pin number 6, this would be digital pin number 5, and this is digital pin number 4. Inside the center rail is our voltage pins. They're 5 volts. And then the last set of pins are ground pins. So on the servo over here, we have three colored wires. We have a brown, a red, and an orange. The brown is ground, the red is voltage, and the orange is signal. To connect it, all we have to do is take the cable, bring it over to digital pin 11, which is the one we're going to be using, and then place it on the pins. So as you can see, we have our signal, we have our 5 volts, and then we have our ground. So in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface, or excuse me, in Marlin, how we're going to load it. But first, before we can do that, we need to connect the big side of the USB to the MKS Gen version 1.4. And then we need to connect the small side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, first thing we want to do is open up Marlin-Bugfix-2.0.x. We then want to open up the Marlin subfolder. Then we want to open up the source folder and the core folder. Inside the core folder, we want to open up the boards file. This is boards.h. And we're going to search on MKS. And as you can see, there are several MKS, but the one we're interested in is board underscore MKS underscore gen underscore 1.3. So we're going to copy that. We're going to close out of this. We're going to go up one directory, then another. Then we're going to click on marlin.ino and open that up. Okay, now we want to connect or select the configuration.h tab. Want to do a search on motherboard, and we want to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 1.4 underscore EFB and paste what we copied from the other file, being board underscore MKS underscore gen underscore 1.3. So to install the servo, we have to do a search on num underscore servo. And as you can see, currently it's commented out, so we need to remove the comments by backspacing. And the number of servos says 3, but we're only using 1. So we're going to change that to a 1. And then if you want, you can set the delay. Right now it's just under a third of a second, so it's 300 milliseconds. But what we want to do next is load the firmware. So we have to go over to Tools. We have to select the right board or processor type. So we have to find the Adreno Mega 2560. Next, we have to make sure that we have a COM port selected, which is going to be COM port 3. And then we have to click the Upload button. What will happen is this will compile our changes and upload it to the MKS Gen version 1.4. In a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how we're going to test it. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder, so we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the MKS Gen version 1.4. And to move the servo, what we're going to type is M280
for the G-code, P0 being the first servo, and we're going to move it to the zero position, so S0. And then we're going to see what happens when I press enter. Okay, as you can see, it moved to the zero position. Now let's see what happens when it moves to the 90 degree position. So we're just changing the S0 to 90. Now I'm going to press enter, and we'll see what happens. So as you can see, it moved to the 90 degree position. If you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.